It is Louisiana, so the longer we're out here, the hotter it's going to get. But it's nice to be at worship with you, even though it's in the parking lot. This morning, after worship, we're going to meet and discuss about regathering. And so that information will be out this week through Facebook and text message and perhaps phone calls. But we will get that information out to you about our church regathering. Again, it's nice to be with you this morning as we worship. And this is a weekend that we remember the sacrifice that soldiers have made on our behalf. And we are very grateful for the sacrifices of our soldiers. And with that, as we worship also to glorify Jesus, let's remember what the soldiers have done and what Christ has done for us, for our freedom. We're no longer enslaved in sin, but we are free in Christ. But let us not use our freedom in a way that we could lose our witness. Amen? Let's go to Him in prayer. Lord, we thank You for a beautiful morning. We're also thankful, Lord Jesus, for all the things that You have done for us, from salvation to justification, Lord, to the living hope that we have in You. And Lord, we pray for the families of those this today that have sacrificed loved ones for the cause of freedom. We ask, Lord, Your touch upon them today as we remember their sacrifice. We pray for our military today, Lord, that are overseas and serving here. We ask Your watch care and protection about them. Help our leaders, Lord, to make good decisions. May they look to You for guidance. Again, Lord, we thank You for our freedom. In Jesus' name, amen.
All right, please join us in singing, "My Eyes Have Seen the Glory."
Mine eyes have seen the glory of the coming of the Lord. He is stamping out the vintage where the grapes of wrath are stored. He has looped the faithful lightning of His terrible swift sword. His truth is marching on. Glory, glory, hallelujah. Glory, glory, hallelujah. Glory, glory, hallelujah. Our God is marching on. He has sounded forth the trumpet that shall never sound retreat. He is sifting out the hearts of men before His judgment seat. Oh, be swift, my soul, to answer Him. Be jubilant, my feet. Our God is marching on. Glory, glory, hallelujah. Glory, glory, hallelujah. Glory, glory, hallelujah. Our God is marching on. He is coming like the glory of the morning on the wave. He is wisdom to the mighty, He is honor to the brave. So the world shall be His footstool and the soul of wrong is slave. Our God is marching on. Glory, glory, hallelujah. Glory, glory, hallelujah. Glory, glory, hallelujah. Our God is marching on. God of our fathers, God of our fathers, whose almighty hand leads forth in beauty all the story past. joyful songs before thy throne arise. Thy love divine hath led us in the past. In this relent, by thee our lot is cast. Be thou our ruler, guardian, guide, and stay. Chosen way. Refresh thy people on their toilsome way. Lead us from night to never-ending day. With love and grace divine, and glory, love, and praise be ever thine.
My country, 'tis of thee.
My country, 'tis of thee, sweet land of liberty, of thee I sing. Land where my fathers died, land of the pilgrims fly, from every mountainside let freedom ring. My native country, the land of the noble free, thy name I love. I love my rocks and rills, thy woods and templed hills. My heart with rapture thrills like that above. Our Father's God, to thee offer of liberty, to thee we sing. Long may our land be bright with freedom's holy light. Protect us by thy might, great God, our King.
At this moment, we're going to take time to honor those that have fallen in battle for the cause of our country and with the playing of taps. So if you please revet yourselves in your cars and take a moment to remember those that have fallen. And my wife and I are going to play taps. Let's pray. Dear Father, we love you so much. We thank you for bringing us today on this beautiful morning. Thank you for your sunshine. Thank you for your grace and mercy that you show us day in and day out. Thank you for sending us brave men and women to fight for our country. and thank you for the sacrifice that some of them have made for our country. Lord, we thank you so much for them. Lord, it's a special kind of person, a special kind of family to be able to endure. We thank you so much for that. We thank you for sending your son, Jesus, who died on the cross for our sins. Lord, we love you, and I thank you for everything. Give you all my praise at this time. Just thanking you for everything you've done for us. Lord, we ask that you bless Brother TC as he sings in just a moment. Bless our pastor. Give them the right words to say to us today to help bring us closer to the one that can save us, Jesus Christ. And I pray all these things in the precious name of our Savior, Jesus. Amen.
Never forget. He was a troubled kid in and out of jail. When his father said, "This is the last time I pay bail." So he enlisted in the army, and they sent him to Iraq. He was a different man when he came back. Somebody said the army must have whooped you into shape. He said, "That's not the reason that I changed. Somebody died for me before I even asked for help. Gave their life for me when I couldn't save myself. I cannot live the way I live or be the way I was. Every day's a gift to me because somebody died for me." Flag and attach the silver star. Then they fold the flag and attach the silver star. As a grieving mother leans against his arms, then he stands before the family and somehow tries to tell how he survived the night his best friend fell. No one that ever knew him was surprised he died that way. He always lived for Jesus, and he always used to say, "Somebody died for me before I even asked for help. Gave their life for me when I couldn't save myself. I cannot live the way I live or be the way I was. Every day's a gift to me because somebody died for me. And I don't want to waste the moment of the time that I have left. With every breath I'm given, God help me not forget. God help me not forget. Somebody died for me when I couldn't save myself. Gave their life for me before I even asked for help. I cannot live the way I live or be the way I was. Every day's a gift to me because somebody died for me." Somebody. somebody died for me. Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Brother T.C. That was wonderful. Please turn the Bible with me this morning to Psalm 77. Psalm 77. Yesterday evening, I watched the Green Beret. With John Wayne, and that's a movie that I have watched off and on since childhood, and that movie kind of prepared me for this weekend as we remember Memorial Day. Tomorrow, the ones who have given the ultimate sacrifice for our freedom as a nation. And we're called to remember those sacrifices. It seems like we live in a time with very short memories, that we forget with the next news cycle what happened last week, because this week there's a whole new news cycle, and it seems like Americans, at least the younger generations, forget very easily the cost of our freedom. Men and women giving their lives under orders to go in combat or go in harm's way to serve their country. As they were giving their lives, they remembered us. They remembered their families at home. They remembered their homeland as they would go and serve our nation's interests in foreign lands. I'm very grateful, and we should all, I know you are also, of the gifts that our soldiers have given us. We have peace. We can go home. We do not have bombs going off in our backyard. We do not really know or understand how it's like to have a war zone in our nation. The early parts of our nation, they knew what a war zone was like in the homeland, but you and I just had a little small taste of it on 9/11. On the way to church this morning, I was listening to American Family Radio about a country, Yemen, who's been in a civil war now for 5 years, and now they are hard hit with the COVID-19 virus. Most of their hospitals are damaged, no longer in use because of their civil war, and now they are fighting the virus on top of that. You see, we do not know nor understand what that is like. But our soldiers, we need to say thank you. And thank you to the families who sacrificed loved ones so that you and I cannot fully grasp what a war zone is like in our homeland. That is what we are grateful for, remembering their sacrifices. In the Bible, we're told to remember many things. In the Bible, they set up monuments, mostly in the Old Testament, so that the generations after them would look at that monument to remember how God miraculously delivered them in that particular situation. In this psalm, the theme of this psalm, 77, you can title it trouble. Just plain trouble. And we're going to read how the psalmist, in time of trouble, how he doubted. He felt like God was not listening to him, that where is God? God is in his sanctuary. God is so holy that he is unaware of the trouble that he is in. And we get to experience the feelings of the psalmist in his trouble. But he's also going to work through that trouble by faith and remember how God had delivered before and how God will deliver again. So let's get into this psalm, Psalm 77. He says, I cried out to God in verse 1 with my voice. To God with my voice. You can see the pain that he is in and how he emphasized that he was crying out with his whole being out to God. He mentions it twice. And he gave ear to me. And you and I, as born again believers, know that when we cry out to God, he hears us. We do not have to go through somebody else. You don't have to come through me for me to pray for you. No, you, because of the sacrifice Jesus made on the cross, the veil of the temple was ripped in half. Now you and I have access to the Holy of Holies, where God is, where his mercy seat is. So he hears us. And the psalmist says, he gave ear to me. Verse 2, in the day of my trouble, I sought the Lord. Now this day does not represent a 24-hour period. It does not represent just time of daylight. But this represents a period of time in his life. So in the day of my trouble, I sought the Lord. My hand was stretched out in the night without ceasing. My soul refused to be comforted. I remembered God and was troubled. I complained and my spirit was overwhelmed. He cried out in the nighttime and he cried out to God. He prayed and he prayed. And yet he still felt overwhelmed. I've been there. Have you? Verse 4. You hold my eyelids open. He just couldn't sleep. He tossed and turned and he just sleep evaded him. He could not rest because of the trouble. He says, I am so troubled that I cannot speak. I have considered the days of old, the years of ancient times. I call to remembrance my song in the night. I meditate within my heart, and my spirit makes diligent search. He was remembering times of past, and he searched within his heart. He pondered about times of past times. You see, real faith, mature faith, strong faith causes us to remember. Now, we don't live in the past, but we do remember, and true faith, real faith, takes time and thought. He meditated on it. He pondered upon it. And it took time and much thought. And he asked these questions. Will the Lord cast off forever? This is how he questioned his trouble. This is how he questioned his suffering. And will he be favorable no more? Will God hear me anymore? Will God move on my behalf anymore? He says in verse 8, has his mercy ceased forever? Has his promise failed forevermore? Has God forgotten to be gracious? Has he in anger shut up his tender mercies? So during this pondering, this meditating, this remembrance of years gone by, the good times, back when the sound of little feet through the house brought peace, back when it seemed like there was no trouble in life, you just went to work and you came home and you enjoyed it. Back when you remember him. Back when God seemed was so gracious, and now because of trouble we question and we ask, has God forgotten me? Has God shut up his tender mercies? Let's read on. He's working through these feelings. We get a glimpse of this time of trouble, the thoughts in his head, the thoughts of his heart. We get a glimpse of it. But listen to this. That's not the end. He says, and I said, this is my anguish, but I will remember the years of the right hand of the Most High. You see, he saw that time of questioning, the time of, has God forgotten me forever? He saw that as his weakness, but not God's. He saw that as his personal warfare within his heart and mind. It was his weakness and not God's negligence towards him. That was his anguish. But he will remember. He says in verse 11, I will remember the works of the Lord. Surely I will remember your wonders of old. He will remember all the times in the scriptures how God delivered his people. Personally, he will remember the day of his salvation. He will remember all the times, the difficulties of life. Remember how God brought him through time and time and time again. He says in verse 12, I will also meditate on all your work and talk of your deeds. Not just stay in the anguish of mind and heart, but he will also talk of how good God is, even in during the trouble. He will talk about all the gracious acts of God, even in the time of trouble, because God is good all the time. The good days and the bad days, God is good. He'll talk about it. In verse 13, we see, working through those feelings, remembering God, remembering how God brought him through, we come now to the other side of his thought process, the other side of his heart, how God gently worked in his life. On the other side, we see this. Your way, verse 13, O God, is in the sanctuary. Who is so great a God as our God? This is a revelation of God. It's a revelation of God's character. God is holy. God is love. God is righteous. God is. And it's a revelation of God to us. We have His revelation, His written word. And we also have God revealing Himself in the flesh, through the flesh of Christ Jesus. God revealed Himself to us in Jesus Christ. If we want to know God now, we must look to Jesus. But this is God's self-revelation of Himself. Everything that we know about God is because God has revealed it to us. Today we have the Holy Spirit. And let me say this. If you think God has revealed something to you that is contrary to His Word, it's not from God. It's a different spirit. So we have God's self-revelation, His Word, and we have Jesus Christ. And we have the Spirit of God in us as born-again believers that shows us the truth. The truth of God's Word. The truth who Jesus is. So, Your way, O God, is in the sanctuary. Who is so great a God as our God? You are the God who does wonders. You have declared Your strength among the peoples. You have with Your arm redeemed Your people, the sons of Jacob and Joseph. So He looks all the way back to Genesis. Just like you and I, when we came to faith in Christ, you and I had to believe what God's Word says. And it goes all the way back to Genesis. In the beginning, God. In the beginning, God. Verse 16. The water saw You, O God. The water saw You. They were afraid. The depths also trembled. The clouds poured out water. The sky sent out a sound. Your arrows also flashed about. This is a description of creation. The voice of Your thunder was in the whirlwind. The lightnings lit up the world. The earth trembled and shook. Verse 19. Your way was in the sea. We're getting back to His way. He says, Your path in the great waters, and Your footsteps were not known. You led Your people like a flock by the hand of Moses and Aaron. So on the other side of this self-empathy, this self of saying, woe is me, the other side of that, is God really listening? The other side of that is looking at God's self-revelation to us. His way. He is the Creator. He is the sustainer of all life. And He hears us. Self-revelation. So what's the solution? The solution in trouble as God's people, yes, cry out to God. Tell God your heart. He already knows. Cry out to Him. Remember footsteps of faith. Remembering the past, but looking forward by faith. We're walking by faith. Someday it'll be by sight, but today it's by faith. And remember God's self-revelation to us. So how does that apply to us? Many, many scriptures in the New Testament, but let's just turn to one. Turn to Hebrews chapter 4. Hebrews chapter 4. Hebrews chapter 4, beginning in verse 14. Seeing then that we have a great high priest who has passed through the heavens, Jesus, the Son of God, let us hold fast our confession. In trouble, hold fast. Hold fast your confession. Your faith is in the Lord Jesus Christ. Our access is in Christ Jesus, the very Son of God. Hold fast that confession, because He is the strong one. Our flesh is weak, but in Him we are strong. So how do we hold fast? We simply believe what Jesus has said and what Jesus has done. We simply believe God's self-revelation of Himself to us. Hold fast to that. Verse 15. For we do not have a high priest who cannot sympathize with our weaknesses, but was in all points tempted as we are, yet without sin. He's the sinless one. He is the Lamb without spot or blemish. But remember this, the time in trouble when we say, has God forgotten me? Has God forgotten us? Where is God and all of that? Why did this happen? Why did that happen? I remember the times past how God was so good. What about today? I'm in trouble today. It's been a season of trouble. Remember this. Jesus hanging on the cross said Himself, my God, why hast Thou forsaken me? Jesus knows Himself about trouble. It's not trouble because He did sin that caused trouble. It's not trouble that He Himself did, but it is the trouble of the experiencing of the sin of the world being placed upon Him. My sin, your sin was placed upon Jesus on the cross. He paid the ultimate once for all sacrifice for sin on our behalf. He knows. He knows what it's like to weep. He knows what it's like to feel lonely. He knows what it's like even to feel forsaken by God. He can sympathize with us. But even in that, it says in verse 16, let us therefore come boldly to the throne of grace. Cry out to God. You can do it boldly. You can, again, that veil was ripped from top to bottom. God did it so that you and I can reach the mercy seat of God. Let us therefore come boldly to the throne of grace, that we may obtain mercy and find grace. The Apostle Paul said, he cried out to God. He said, God, remove this thorn in my flesh. He asked it three times. And yet he found grace. Jesus said, told him, my grace is sufficient. My grace is sufficient. So, that we may obtain mercy and find grace to help in time of what? In time of need. In time of need. In time of trouble. In time of heartache. In time of hardship. Hold fast. Hold fast your confession. Jesus paid it all. All to Him I owe. Sin had left a crimson stain, but He washed it white as snow. So during times, even like this, time, the time in which we are living in, we realize that Jesus, and only Jesus, is our only hope during times like this. Amen. Hold fast, church. Hold fast our confession. Let us pray. Lord, in this time, we pray that You will give us strength. God, I know there are members of my church family that are experiencing a season of trouble, a season of hardship. Some of them, Lord, their heart is broken. But God, I pray strength for them. May they bring that brokenness and lay it at Your feet. Lord Jesus, You was broken on our behalf. So God, I pray that You'll give them grace. May they find mercy, Lord, as they lay it upon You. Lord, I know also that there are church family that are rejoicing. Lord, they're in a time of refreshing, a time of renewal. And God, I ask Your blessing upon them also and strength for them. Because in a time of trouble, they will be able to remember this time of how You, Lord, blessed them. Lord, we ask that You'll give us faith. Give us faith, Lord, to take a step. Give us faith, Lord, to take each day a step at a time until our faith becomes sight and we are with You for all eternity. Help us to recognize Your presence that we are promised and assured of by Your self-revelation. God, we will give You the glory. Thank You for the freedom. Thank You, Lord, for the freedom that we have in You, Jesus. In Your name, amen. God bless you. Again, how we will meet again will be out on Facebook, text message. You can call the church office by Tuesday. And Tuesday on and find out how we will meet. If we meet in a building, which building we will meet in. And we will get that information out to you as soon as we can. God bless you and keep safe.